No-code tools empower us to do so much that we couldn't do with just using spreadsheets. One of my favorite no-code tools is SmartSuite, and in this video, I'm going to show you how it gets even more powerful when it's integrated with third-party tools. In our example, we're going to integrate SmartSuite with Zapier and create Google Drive folders automatically. If learning more about this type of an integration is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools. And one of our favorite no-code tools is exactly what we're talking about today, namely SmartSuite. And we're going to be integrating it with another tool called Zapier. Now, before we get into the heart of the video, I first want to invite you to join me for some automation training. Automation is one of those key building blocks of all no-code solutions. It's going to empower you to reclaim your time and automate your repetitive, mundane tasks, and ultimately allow you to focus on higher value work than copy-paste. I'm going to show you exactly how to unlock the full power of automation in my free automation training. You can grab it at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of things. I want to talk about SmartSuite and integrating it with Google Drive. And in this particular instance, we're going to use a third-party tool in order to get that middleware component solved, and we're going to be using Zapier. Now, Zapier is not our only option. We might also look at other things like Make. There are several other tools in the no-code space that kind of act in that middleware function that allow us to talk from one platform to another. But we're going to be using Zapier in our example today, so let's dive on into it. I encourage you to follow along with me in your own SmartSuite account. If you don't already have one, sign up using our link below. So here we go, I'm inside of my SmartSuite here, and you can see that I'm on one of SmartSuite's new dashboards. Now, I love what SmartSuite has done with this new dashboard feature. It's still in development, new things are rolling out, but you can see here that I've got a setup with an internal content dashboard where I'm tracking our production. So I've got a calendar here where I'm looking at the very video that we're recording right now, how to integrate Google Drive and SmartSuite to create folders. Now that title may change, but ultimately that is what we're working on here. We've got a publication date, raw files, a final file. We've linked to our partner. We've linked to other software that we're working with, in this case, Zapier, in addition to SmartSuite. And so you can see that we've got all the different components of the record here. But what we need is to actually have some sort of recording process. And so that's what's built here in my next page, where I can select from our different records that are scheduled. And you can see them right here. I have a better breakdown of that information, but what I really love is having one place where I can go, boom, click that button and open up my Google Drive folder. But I don't want to have to create these folders every time manually. That is a lot of work coming in here, making sure that I'm in the right YouTube raw files, which is my parent folder, and then creating a new folder inside of it that is specific to this video, and then creating yet another folder inside of it that is for my raw files. So you can see here that I've actually got this all done already. It's the final file, the raw files for this video, how to integrate Google Drive and SmartSuite. So this was all created via automation, and that's what we're going to be breaking down here. So first and foremost, we might flip into SmartSuite and look at their own automations internally. These are the native automations available in SmartSuite. You can see that I have already another automation here for some separate process. I use automation a lot, and when I can, I'll build it natively in the database tool. So in this case, if I can build it in SmartSuite, I will. But if we look at SmartSuite's options and we're looking at their action steps, I'm just going to pick a random trigger here. Let's say we're looking for that action. We see that they have an integration with Google Drive, but when we hover over it, all that we get as an action here natively is uploading a file. And we want to go deeper than that. We want to integrate with Google Drive, but we want to create folders, right? We don't want to just upload files to Google Drive. So instead of building that automation then inside of SmartSuite, let's exit here, and we're going to use that middleware component, in this case, Zapier. Here's what that automation looks like. I've entitled it Create Folders for Video Files. We're going to dive in and take this one step at a time. Now, SmartSuite has this option for a trigger inside of Zapier. So let's dive in. It's called Update a Record. And when we update a record, any update to a record in a specific table is going to trigger the automation. So this is actually a lot of different automation updates that are going to happen here, but we don't want to perform our automation for every updated record. So you can see that I'm looking at my content production solution, and then I'm looking at the table of video content. So if we rewind back to SmartSuite, that's this. Content production is the solution, video content is the table. But back now inside of Zapier, this is, as I was saying, going to trigger our Zapier automation off of every updated record in this table. And there's a lot of updates to these records. People are moving the status all the time. We're moving it through the production process. It goes into editing. It goes into uploading. It gets published. We might change the date. We might change the title. Lots of updates. So how do we know which of these we actually want to perform the automation on? Well, we have a filter as our second step. This is a filter by Zapier, and if we look at it and how we've configured it, we said, look, there has to be a video title. If we don't have a title for this video, we certainly aren't ready to create folders for it. Now, this is a key takeaway in any automation you build. Make sure that you have the information you need in order to fulfill the rest of the automation. Specifically in this case, we are going to create the folder in Google Drive, and we're going to use the video title in the naming of the folder. So we need to make sure that a video title exists. But beyond that, we also want to make sure that we don't already have URLs inside a SmartSuite. So if we already created the Google Drive folder and saved that URL back in SmartSuite, well, then we don't want to do it again. So again, in our filter, we're saying, not only do we have to have a video title, but we also need to make sure that we do not have the final file URL. And we need to make sure that we do not have a raw file URL. And we need to make sure that we've moved this into the stage of recording. So if we flip back one more time into our SmartSuite to take a look, this title must have information. This raw files button has to be looking at another field for raw files that does not exist. And this stage right here must be set to recording. And similarly, we have that final files as well. So only when all four of those conditions are simultaneously met, then will our automation move forward. And the nice thing about Zapier is the way that they've put their pricing, we do not get charged for Zapier automation tasks for triggers or for filters. So if something does not meet these conditions, we are not going to get charged on our account against our tasks because these particular action steps, the trigger and the filter, are free. So now we're getting to the part where we're actually going to perform the automation, and that is where we're going to actually consume tasks in our account. So we build our first parent folder. Remember that we had the parent folder that was the video title, and then inside of that folder, we have two different files or different folders, one for the raw files and one for the final files. So here we're creating that parent folder, and we set it up like this. What is the name of the drive or the highest level that you are sharing? And we have a folder in our Google Drive called the YouTube Raw Files. Now, the nice thing about this is I've given access to our editing team, to our publishing team, to this overall drive. So every new subfolder inside of this is going to be automatically shared with the right people on the team. Now, we don't have a parent folder beyond that. So the highest level folder is YouTube Raw Files. And after that, we're going to create this folder. And we are going to name it with the title of this video. So the title of the sample data was 004 SmartSuite TBD. Now, that's not the actual title of the video. When we move forward, you'll see the actual title get plugged in when we test the automation. But now we're creating that parent folder. And now we're going to dial in two layers deeper. Well, with one layer deeper two times, we're going to say, now that we have that, we're going to create another Google Drive folder. We're going to create the raw files folder this time. And this time, we're going to say the highest level drive is the YouTube raw files. But now we're going to build it. This is now going to be inside of the parent folder that we created in the previous step. So this is right here, dynamic data. We're bringing in the parent folder that was created in step three. And we are using the ID right here. Map to that ID, and then the file that we build inside of it is going to be the subfolder called raw files. Now we're going to do the exact same thing in our final files folder. So here we're going to say we're going to create that again in our YouTube raw files. We're again plugging into this parent folder. Note that we could access the folders that we created here if we needed to. We could go two, three, four, five layers deep if we needed to build folders inside of folders. For us, we don't. We're going back to that parent folder right here, and this particular file is going to be called final file every time. Now, the last step of this is going to be taking the files that we just created, the folders that we just created, and we need to bring that information back into SmartSuite so that we have a consolidated place of where we're doing this, right? So we're going to say, well, now we're going to update that record. So back in here, we want to update the record that triggered the automation, which is right here, the record ID from step one. And what do we want to update? Well, we want to update the raw files URL with the link that we created in step four, our raw files folder. And then we want to update a field called final file URL. And we're going to plug in the link that we created in step five, where we had our final folder creation. Now, you might also notice here that we included a title. This is a kind of wonky thing about SmartSuite, that inside of SmartSuite settings, we have told it that we require an entry in the title of every record. And so Zapier is saying, well, you have to fill out some information here. Now, if we were to look inside of SmartSuite, I'm looking particularly at going to our grid view content here, and we're looking at the title field. You see that this is auto-generated. So it actually doesn't matter what we pass to it from Zapier. Nothing is gonna ever override here. So it doesn't actually matter what we're plugging in. This name is auto-generated for us. Now, if we did not have it set to auto-generate, if it was on manual input, we could toggle off that this needs to be unique or it needs to have an entry, and then that would solve this problem for us. But we're just using a formula to calculate the name of every record, so we really don't worry about that. So I only want to highlight that for you so that when you are here inside of Zapier, as you're mapping and updating a record inside of SmartSuite, it doesn't matter what the title is. If it is auto-generated, you can pretty much plug anything there. It's not going to actually impact your data. So once we have this all set up, we publish our Zap or our automation, and then we can take it out for a spin. So let's go into SmartSuite and make sure that we have a new record that we update that meets these conditions. So in this case, I've got a video coming up that's planned for November 4th. Let's imagine that we were going to test a name. We say test name. So remember, we needed that video title to meet our conditions, and then we put it into the recording stage. Well, this is going to trigger our automation because any updates to a record, remember, will be sent to Zapier, and Zapier will then filter to see, is it in the recording stage? Does it in fact have a video name? Does it have a raw files URL, etc.? And you can see that as I was just yammering on, we now have a file here that we can click. So what did Zapier do? Well, we would plug in and we would on the left-hand side go to Zap Runs and take a look. We'll reset or refresh here to see that we just had a successful run right here. And so this particular run is where we're gonna see all that information. Here's the name, test name. That's the name I just entered in for this video. And so you can see that we properly created the parent folder and then the raw files, the final files, etc. And the reason that this is so valuable is now our team doesn't have to bounce between all these software and forget where things are and are they in the right place. All they had to do was update the stage, right? Now, a simple click away, they're gonna open up a folder. It's gonna be in our YouTube raw files. It's gonna have the proper name for this video and it's gonna be to the raw files URL. And if we need to get to that final files URL, it's right in this parent folder. So as you can see, automation is a very powerful thing and it's going to save you a ton of time. This is something that I would hate to have to do manually every day. But instead, simple push of a button, we're done. I hope you got a ton of value out of this video. If you did, be sure to like and subscribe. And of course, swing by our website if you have other questions. But most importantly, my friend, don't forget, keep on building.